This question is given in GATE 2007. Okay, let's see this question. The circuit diagram of a standard TTL NOT gate is shown in this figure. VA equal to 2.5 volts. The mode of operation of these transistors will be, okay, here they have given four transistors Q1, Q2, Q3 and Q4. They are asking the transistor is operating in which mode, okay. Here VA equal to 2.5 volts applied. And they are saying that it is a standard TTL. Standard TTL. Okay. TTL NOT gate. Okay. They are given four options. Okay. They are saying like Q1 is in reverse active, normal active, saturation, cutoff. Likewise, they are given different combinations of the options. You see here standard TTL NOT gate. There are two possibilities of this gate, okay. First one is it is in on state, another one is off state. Whenever you are applying logic 1, okay, logic 1 or active high input, then we can say that it is on state, okay. Whenever you are applying logic 1, okay, whenever you are applying logic 0, it will be in off state. So this will be called active region, okay. This will be cutoff region. This we can say as saturation region also, okay. Saturation region. This is one of the important point you should keep in mind. The standard TTL NOT gate, we have two possibilities. First one is on, second one is off. So whenever we are applying high logics or logic 1, it is said to be in active region or saturation region. Whenever you are applying logic 0, it is in cutoff region. Okay. Now we will see logic level diagram of this TTL gate. Okay. Logic diagram, logic levels. Coming to this logic levels. So it starts at basically 0.8. to 2 volts, sorry, 0 to 0.8, okay, 0 to 0.8, it is called logic 0, okay, this is called logic 0, and from 2 to 5, it is called logic 1, okay, these are the voltages. Whenever you are applying 0 to 0.8, it is called logic 0, or transistor is in off state, okay. Whenever you are applying 2 to 5 volts, transistor is in on state. This is the logic level diagram you should keep in mind. If you observe here, VA equal to 2.5 volts. 2.5 volts is somewhere here, okay. Now, this is called logic high. Here we are applying logic high to this NPN transistor. This transistor is NPN because you see this diagram, arrow mark indicates this emitter, this will be base and this will be collector. And you are applying 2.5 volts to here and coming to this VCC is applied, 5 volts applied through this 4 kilo ohm and some voltage drop across this 4 kilo ohm and here definitely the voltage will be less than 2 volts. Okay. So for N side, here N side for Q1, with respect to Q1 I am talking. For N side, you are applying 2.5 volts. For P side, you are applying less than 2 volts. N side is more positive compared to P side. So, this will be in reverse bias. Okay. So, this transistor is in reverse bias. As this is in reverse bias, so no current flows through this circuit. So, no current flows through this circuit. The entire current has to flow through this only. Like what is this emitter base collector? So the entire current has to flow through collector base junction of Q1, okay, collector base junction of Q1, okay. So Q1 we can say that this is in reverse active region is nothing but the opposite of active region. Here the current is, here voltage difference if you observe, input is 2.5 volts. For this side it is 2 volts, So current does not flow through this because of it is in reverse bias. So current has to flow through this collector to base junction. Okay, collector to base junction. This will be in active reverse active region. Now if you observe here for the Q2, this is emitter, this is base, this is collector. Large amount of current flows through this Q2. Okay, large amount of current flows through this Q2. So Q2 is in forward bias. Q2 is in forward bias and it is in on state. On state. When Q2 is in on state, it is said to be in active region. Active region or saturation region. Okay. So the large amount of current flows through this resistor, and for this resistor the voltage drop is greater than 0.7 volts. If it is greater than 0.7 volts, so it has to flow through this, which makes Q3 also in on state. Q3 also forward bias and it is in on state, so it is in saturation, active region or saturation, you can say anything. Okay, saturation. Okay, now all the current is flowing through in this direction only. A little amount of current flows through this direction. Okay, all the current flows through this direction only. A little amount of current flows through this direction, which makes Q4 off state. Which makes Q4 off state is nothing but cutoff state. Cut off state. Okay, now coming to the answer, Q1 should be in reverse active, Q2 saturation, Q3 saturation, Q4 cutoff. If you see the options, reverse active, saturation, saturation, cutoff. So option B is the correct answer for this question. Okay, how we have solved this, you have to look into this diagram carefully. Now this diagram looks clumsy. If you have any doubt, you just pass the video. You can recollect the video what I have said earlier. The main point is, by looking into the logic circuit, whenever this transistor, the first current flows through this direction is not possible because of this is in reverse bias. Whenever transistor is in reverse bias, so the transistor has to allow the current to pass through this common collector to base terminal. So current is flowing in this direction, very huge amount of current, which makes Q2 on. On is nothing but it is in saturation, and current has to flow through this resistor, which is having greater than 0.7 volts, the potential difference, large currents. Okay, and very little amount of current flows through this Q4, which makes Q4 is in off state. Okay, now Q3 is also in forward bias, which makes it is in on state, so it is in saturation. That is how we got the solution.